like in the modern world, what is happening? The adult world, adults, actually the parents as well as the adult world, equate education with marks. That is, they ask the child, we are going to admit you in the school. Then the child will ask the question, why should I go to school? Then they will go to, you go to school, then you will get good marks. Okay, what will happen if I get good marks? Then you get a good job. Then what will happen? You will earn a lot of money. Then you can live very comfortably. So, we are present day world, we are telling the children that education is to be given, or we have to get educated to live comfortably. That is a materialistic attitude that has come in. But that is not the aim of education. The aim of education is to make the child to stand on his own legs so that he can himself make a comfortable life for himself. That is only a byproduct actually. But we normally connect education with earning of money. And the activity that is going on here and the school has taken up may be baffling for some parents, because whenever any cultural I come from a system where a lot of co-curricular activities are conducted. I hear parents coming to us in the meetings and telling that in the school a lot of activities are only going on, no studies. What is studies? If for a small child you are seeing on the stage today, then you ask them, you give a questionnaire to them and ask them, which are the happiest days in your life? In the last year and this year, they will say that today is the happiest life. Yesterday was that, and today afternoon also was the happiest days in life. Because classrooms and the school system is suffocating actually for such young children. Because this is the time when they have to play, they have to enjoy their life, they have to grow in the space given to them. That is why education should not be equated with classroom teaching. That is one part. Because in one of the shlokas in Mahabharata, it is said that one form of education is approved by teaching. That is 25% education is we get by teaching. Other one-fourth by self-learning, the next one-fourth by peer group learning, and the last 25% by experiential learning. So this is what learning. Learning is not only from the schooling or classroom or formal education. 70% of learning is to take the child attends through the informal interaction that it has with the peer group, has with the it has in self-learning and through experiential learning. And that type of education, if it is given, no child will be failing in their life. But when we are going in the wild goose chase now, comparing the children, that last time you have got, I told you to get 100 marks, you have got only 99.5, crashing the child. I have seen it, my own colleagues in the schools used to do. See, that is not that. See, because finally what a child will evolve as, we do not know. That is why Swami Vivekananda actually talks about, when he talks about what is education, he says that we want that education by which character is built, strength of mind is increased, intellect is expanded, by which one can stand on one's own legs. Education is not the amount of information that is put into your brain and runs right there throughout your life. If you have one idea and assimilated it as your life's idea or ambition, you are more educated than a man who has digested the entire library. That's what Vivekananda writes about education. That's why we should not feel that this type of activities when the school is conducting, that studies are not going on and homeworks are not being done, all things. This is also part of education. This is the real education that the child gets. Because bookish knowledge will not help the child to face the society in future. Einstein, one of the greatest scientists, says, "What is education? Education is that which remains with you when everything taught in the school is forgotten. You just understand this." What Einstein says about education is, education is that which remains with you when everything taught in the school is forgotten. That is it. So that is what. So if you have to give good atmosphere for the children to grow as good human beings, good citizens. You saw that excellent records have been shown. If they are all multiplication tables actually. They are all about values of life. And highly educated people are detrimental to the nation. Many cases I am talking about. And uneducated people are more patriotic in many cases. So what is the use of an education which creates people who become detrimental to the existence of the nation? So that is why value systems are very, very important, and the children are carrying the placards. I was quite happy to see that these are the values that have been taught to the children and cannot be taught. It has to be emulated. So we have to follow that in our home and in our school as well as. Then automatically children will have a role model that we have to be like this. And this is what is going to give me glory and appreciation and praise in the society in future rather than anything else. As well as adults, we have to give them correct models, be good role models for them, of impeccable character, of good behavior and habits, and children will automatically have them. Because they come and tell us that this fellow is spoiled. He is not listening to me. Because the model that he is seeing teaches him. That is why we as adults are very, very careful when we are handling the children. I appreciate the school for taking up this initiative. It is a very mega, big initiative actually. Making so many children to be trained and coming on the stage and calling so many parents and arranging it in a big way. It's an excellent initiative taken by the school, and I pray God that we should give them more strength and more impetus, and see that in the years to come this grows, this activity grows, and more number of children participate in this program. And parents don't feel that these are all disturbing the learning process. It is not disturbing, these are all complementing to the learning process. And the child, when he is standing on the stage, when he is acting, when he is singing, he is learning what is decision making. He is learning what is problem solving. He is learning excellent communication skills. He is learning leadership qualities. He is learning to leave stage fear. He is learning to face the audience in his neighbor. So these are the qualities that the child requires later on. When he becomes a professional in life, every day he is not going to recite multiplication tables. He has to meet people. He has to guide them, lead them, take decisions, solve problems. That personality development will be taking place in such type of activities. God bless all of you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your inspirational and motivational words. And now, having accepted our invitation, we feel honored by your presence. And now I request to call upon Ekta Ma'am, principal of St. Britto's Academy, to present a small memento as a token of love and appreciation to our chief guest from BPS Sudarshan Rao, CSC Regional Officer. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us today. And we are honored by your presence. Thank you very much.
Palace.
Thank you.
What?